Hello everyone. Today I will explain the paper VoxLab 2 Deep Speaker Recognition. This paper is a second version of a old paper called VoxLab 1, which was released in 2016, I think. And this paper is a second version of that paper. It got released in 2018, a few months ago. So, and this paper is a database paper, and this paper has more data compared to the VoxLab 1 data. So this has more number of speakers also, and this paper gives us an idea of how to collect data from YouTube videos without having human effort, without calling people to give their recordings for speaker identification. So we will cover introduction part, data set collection pipeline, then we'll see what is the network architecture they used for training these speaker identification models, and we'll show some result. This is actually a database paper. So in the introduction, we'll see what is speaker identification or speaker recognition. Speaker recognition is nothing but recognizing a speaker from the audio waveform or audio signal. So in this paper, we will see how computer vision algorithms can be used to collect speaker identification data. Because these days, like before 2015, if you look for any free or open source speaker identification data, you will not get it. So there are challenges like SRE challenge, and there were some data sets which were not public. They give it only for institutional purpose. So those kind of restrictions were there for speaker identification data set, and mostly you will have to buy them from LDC for you have to pay a lot of money, like thousands of dollars, to get this kind of data. So this paper is an effort towards making a free data set which will be available for any researchers to work on. And this paper also shows how we can use algorithms in the other domain, like computer vision algorithms, to get data set for speaker identification. And they show after collecting the data, they show some results on speaker identification using their own data set, which is a VoxLab2 data set using ResNet and VGG networks. And they also show using contrastive loss to train speaker verification network using pre-trained strategy gives better results. So first we'll understand the data collection pipeline. This paper is all about how you collect data, free data, from YouTube using CV, computer vision algorithms. And you can use them for speaker identification. After collecting the data, you can just use them for speaker identification problem. So basically this pipeline includes lots and lots of computer vision algorithms to make sure we are getting the right kind of data from the right person, means right speaker. So it has a whole lot of algorithms. It has face tracking, face verification, active speaker verification, and removing duplicate files using automatic methods. And we'll explain each and every algorithms involved in this work in the coming slides. And after collecting the data, they show some baseline results also. So the full pipeline, you can visualize in this picture. This picture is actually this picture was put in the VoxLab 1 paper. This picture is not there in VoxLab 2 paper. So I took this picture from VoxLab 1. So this actually gives the overall idea of what they are doing to collect the speaker identification data. So it's very simple. Let's say you want Elon Musk's audio data. You want, let's say, 20 minutes of Elon Musk audio data. So you will not get all of it in one place. Either you'll have to sit and manually cut the audio and store everything and collect 20 minutes of audio, which requires human labeling, which is very costly, because you will need not only Elon Musk, you'll need thousands of celebrities' audio data. So how will you do it in automatic way? So what they do is, they want Elon Musk's audio data. So they go to YouTube, and in the YouTube they search for Elon Musk audio, Elon Musk, and along with that they put one more word keyword called interview. So then what happens is all the videos which are there in YouTube where Elon Musk is doing interviews will come in top 100. So they take all top 100 videos. So they can just download it using some crawler. So once they download it, The videos might not have not only Elon Musk, they may have other faces also. They may be other people speaking. It's not only Elon Musk audio, but it is combined with many other people's audio. But what we are interested in is only Elon Musk audio. So what they do is they do face detection of the entire video. Let's say they take one video which is of 10 minutes and they do face detection in the entire video. So once they do face detection, they can apply face tracking. So once they do face tracking, I will explain each and every thing in the coming slide. With the I'll just give you the whole picture. So once they do face tracking, they do something called active speaker verification, where they verify whether the person who is speaking in the person who is moving the lips in the video stream and the person who is the audio which is already there, are they matching or not. Or you can say this active speaker verification, I explain in detail. It's like verifying who is speaker on the who is speaking in the video, which corresponds to the audio. And then they do face verification, and then you get this Vox Celeb data. So finally, so basically, what is happening is you have a video of, let's say, four people speaking in the video. You will do face identification and face tracking. After you do the face tracking, you will know which person is speaking what. But sometimes what happens is even if the audio track is there, but the person may not be moving his lips. That means someone else is speaking, but other person who face is shown. So that case, you'll have to do this active speaker verification. Then after doing that, then you can say you can identify who Elon Musk's face in the entire track, all the tracks, and find out where Elon Musk is present in the video. Then you can put that in Vox Celeb data. So candidate selection, so in the database collection, there you have a lot of algorithms to cover. We have candidate selection, then we have to download the video, then we have to apply face detection, then we have to apply face tracking, then we have to do active speaker verification, and then space verification also. So all these steps I'll explain in detail. So the first step is candidate selection. What is candidate selection? Which person you are interested in? That's the candidate selection, or person of interest. So this is obtained by taking 9,000 celebrities in the world. They can be those celebrities can be in any language. For example, they can be US people or UK people, Indian people or Chinese people, any people. But there are 9,000 faces. So that data set is called VGG face. So VGG face is it's also from the same group, VGG group. So the VGG face has 9,000 celebrities, and for each celebrity they have lots of faces. They have done the same thing, they have crawled it from the web, and that is one of the data sets. So they use that data set to do face verification. So they take 6,000 celebrities out of the 9,000, and they are interested in collecting audio data for those celebrities. You can see there are some Indian actress and some other people also there. That means this data set has a lot of variations with ethnicity. So first next step is, after I want to crawl data for 6,000 celebrities, then you'll have to go and crawl it in YouTube. So for that, what you do this. For example, you know the celebrity name, you will just append a word interview along with the celebrity name, and you'll just punch it in YouTube search bar. Then YouTube will give you many videos, and out of that you take top 100 videos. Sometimes what happens, the videos may be repeating. I will tell you how to remove that repeating things using some automatic algorithm. But now let's say we get 100 videos, and we download all the 100 videos. And each video will have, let's say if I search for Elon Musk, each video will have Elon Musk along with that some other people speaking. Now you have to do face tracking. Now I will show you one small face tracking output which I have got when I ran face tracking using this CNN or SST based face detection algorithm and position based tracking. So this is the output
that
I got.
Significant difference in space flight and help make space flight accessible to almost anyone.
Okay, so you saw what happened was, when I did this face detection and face tracking, there were two people doing interview. There were two people in the interview video. So what happens is, when you do the face detection face tracking, so you will get segments of places where Elon Musk is speaking and segments of places where the other guy is speaking. So this is the advantage of using face tracking. So I got 9 second audio of Elon Musk speaking, But sometimes there are some other problems also, because sometimes they show Elon Musk face, but other person will be speaking. I'll tell you how to remove that kind of thing. But when you apply face detection and tracking, this is the kind of output you will expect. Now, after doing face detection, you want to verify whether this is Elon Musk or not. In the entire video, there are a lot of people speaking, but I am interested in the place where only Elon Musk is speaking, right? So for that, I use a face recognition network, which is a ResNet 50 network trained on VGC Phase 2 dataset, which has, as I said, it has 9,000 celebrities, which is called POIs, Person of Interest. Then you can directly do face verification using the classification score, because Elon Musk is there in one of the 9,000 celebrities, and the output of the ResNet is one of output of ResNet gives you the distribution over these 9,000 celebrities. Now, after doing face verification, as I said, sometimes in the video they may be showing Elon Musk face, but other person may be speaking in the background. So even though Elon Musk is there in the video, face will be showing, but some other person may be speaking in the background. So we are not interested in that kind of data. So we have to remove that. So how will you remove that? If you know the person who is speaking, if Elon Musk is not speaking, we can clearly see his face, that his lip is not moving, right? If other person is speaking. So you can do that using something called active speaker verification. So I'll just show in demo of what is active speaker verification.
Whether or not.
So what happens is, here there are three people and there is only one audio track. The goal is, or the problem is, to identify out of these three people who is speaking. This is a very hard problem, because in a single shot you have three faces, and out of those three faces you want to identify who is speaking. This can be done only, these humans can do it very easily, because they can see the hand moving or head moving or even the lip moving, and they can say, okay, this is the person speaking, right? So those things are not that easy to do in computer vision. So they do something called sync nets, or the alignment between the audio and lip. So if the alignment between audio and lip are really good, very good, then we can say, okay, this is the person speaking. So how they do it is, there is one complete paper on only this thing. This is called, that paper is called Out of Time. So that paper says, if you want to know, if you want to sync between the lip and audio, you have to use that kind of network, where they process the lip movements in one network, and they process the audio of that segment in other network, and they try to see how well they are correlated in the hypersphere. Hypersphere in the sense, in the embedding space. If they are correlated very well, the distance will be lower, but if they are not correlated, the distance will be higher. In the same thing, we can do here. We take the audio signal of this clip, and we can take all these three lip movements sequence, and we can find out how close this audio signal embedding, or audio signals in the hypersphere, or audio signals data point, compared to these three. So obviously, since this guy is moving his lips, the audio signal embedding, vector and the lip movement vector will be very close for this person, but will be very far for these two. So that's how this project is done. So you can see here, you can see the demo here.
It matters, I think, for legal reasons.
The blue is the right one, and red is the wrong ones.
It doesn't really matter whether or not you classify
as three different kinds. First of all, the first category I would say is ho-hum. I mean, it
and any number of other things, and this was not just some, you know, private in.
So as you can see, this paper actually shows they got a really good results doing this. I mean, for this active speaker verification on Aulus VS2 dataset. So you can just read more about it. You can just look for the paper Out of Time. So next is the duplicate removal. As I said, sometimes people upload same video in multiple places, and YouTube will give you those videos also in their top 100 result. So what you want to do is, you don't want to keep the same audio for the same person many times. You want to remove it. So for that, what they do is, they have a network, a VGG or a convolutional neural network, where given the audio signal, it computes 1024 dimensional embedding vector. So what is that 1024 1024 dimensional embedding vector do? You can ask. That is some kind of vector which was trained on speaker identification. Now, 1024 dimensional vector for, let's say, Elon Musk speaking at one place, if he speaks the same thing at some other place, that means a repeating video, these two vectors will be almost very close. If it is not the same, then they will be very far. So what they do is they take, after they collect this data using all these steps, they get a lot of data for Elon Musk. So for every segment, they compute this embedding and try to see which are all the vectors which are very close. If some of the vectors are very close with a distance less than 0.01 distance, then they will remove one of them. So that's how you will do duplicate removal. So that's one very good step. So you must have understood the data collection pipeline. Now I will just give you a hint of data statistics. So how much data they collected and what is the statistics. You can see the frequency distribution of the length versus amount of data for each bin. This is kind of histogram plot where they show there is lots and lots of data of sentences of length 0 to let's say 5 seconds, sorry, 0 to 5 seconds. There's huge amount of data, and there's very low amount of data of length 18 seconds, very low amount of audio sequences of length 18 seconds or 20. And here they show how much male data is there. It's almost 61%, and female data is almost 39%. So usually you want to keep both of them 50-50. VoxCelab 1 shows they have 50-50 data, but I don't remember if it's VoxCelab or VGC Face. They have equal amount of data, but here it's a little bit here and there. And here they show the plot for for each country how much data is available. So as you can see, US has the most, 29%, and India is also, India has 6% or something, and Germany has 6%. So that way, so this is the distribution or statistics of the data available for in this VoxCelab 2 paper. Now we will see the network architecture and training procedure. So once you collect the data, so you can't just simply release the data outside. You want to put some baseline results of that data. So it's simply train one baseline convolutional neural network and give the people that, okay, this is what I think for me currently, this is what the results on this data. And later, if some other researchers want to take up this data and improve their result, they can do it. So the same thing was done yesterday. I recently explained one tutorial on unified hyperspear embedding for speaker identification, which is actually the same thing, same data. They have processed the same data and they have put a little bit improvements to the algorithm by adding angular softmax, which was invented for face verification, and additive margin softmax kind of loss functions, and they show some improvements over this data. So that kind of experiments you can do, and you can show, okay, people that my algorithm works better than yours or something like that, right? Now, in the network architecture and training, they have used ResNet 34 and ResNet 50 convolutional neural network. And you can see ResNet 34 has this structure and ResNet 50 has this structure. So for speaker identification, they train with this architecture and the output will be 5994. So 5994 is just the number of speakers available in this data set. So it's supposed to be 6000, but there are some six speaker mix. So 5994 is the number of speakers available for this thing and this. And the training, it's kind of very interesting. So what they do is they first train this network using ResNet, whatever structure I showed. That they call it pre-training. So once that network is trained, you might get some good embeddings. But what these guys show is, if you want to get a very good or improved embeddings, you should use contrastive loss, which is like CMS training a CMS network. So in CMS network, what happens is you will try to minimize the distance between two similar speakers, and you will try to increase the distance between two different speakers. That's a contrastive loss. And you will have two CNN, one process, one stream, another process, another stream. So each one can take similar audio data and reduce the distance, or each one can take different audio data and increase their distance. Or that means you want to cluster, or in the embedding space, if you visualize, you will get all the data points which are, for example, if you have a speaker, 100 data points for one speaker, all those points will be very close to each other, but all other points which are other than this speaker, the data, they will be very far from this cluster. So those will give you very good embeddings which are highly discriminative in nature, and they are going to help you in doing face verification very robust. So the input to this ResNet is 512 cross 300 dimensional spectrogram. 512 is the FFT bin, number of FFT bins, and 300 is just number of feature vectors, and they were calculated for every 25 millisecond audio with a shift of 10 millisecond. Then they use this MatConvert toolkit, which was actually developed by them, by the same group. It's really good these days. It supports GPU, and it has a lot of automatic differentiation automatic differentiation packages and all. So it's good, you can explore it. And they train it using single Titan X GPU for 30 epochs, and they use SGD optimizer. So results, they have done a lot of experiments. As I said, this paper is mostly concentrates on these days people use deep neural network to do any experiments in machine learning or something, but there are a lot of other systems which were invented back in 2015 and 2012, which are like iVector, which is like, it's a very famous thing in speech. iVector with PLDA, they show on VoxLab, they get 8.8% ER, and reduction in ER is nothing but better the system. So if they use VGGM with softmax, they get 10.2. On VoxLab 2, they actually get a little bit of improvement. And as you can see, ResNet 50 actually gives the best result. ResNet 50 on VoxLab 2, it gives best results. So as you can see in the dark, they mentioned here. So that's it, this video. So I'll drop the paper in the section below. You can just watch it, you can just read it, and thank you so much for watching the video.